Monday. This morning, students returned to class at Perry Hall High School just a day after a 15-year-old opened fire inside, critically injuring a 17-year-old. We have team coverage this afternoon. 11 News reporter Kim Dacey is live at the school with how students are coping. And lead I-Team investigative reporter Jane Miller has the latest on the investigation. She's live from CCBC in Dundalk. Jane, you just attended the press conference. What more have you learned?
Well, Sarah, 15-year-old Bobby Gladden was charged late last night as an adult with attempted murder and felony assault. At a news conference just a short time ago, Baltimore County Police Chief James Johnson provided new details of the allegations against the teenager. He says Gladden, a 10th grader at Perry Hall, rode the bus to school yesterday with a double-barreled shotgun broken down in his book bag. Once at school, the chief says, Gladden went to his first and second period classes, then to the cafeteria for lunch. Then the chief says he went and got the gun from a bathroom where he had hidden it, put it together, and got off one shot before being restrained by the guidance counselor and other school staff. That shot hit 17-year-old Danny Barrowy in the lower back. That student, the 17-year-old victim, remains in critical condition. As for motive, the chief says, still unclear.
We are aware of many reports that the suspect was a victim of bullying. We cannot confirm those reports. Robert Gladden's conversations with investigators have not indicated bullying was an issue in this case. The investigation is incomplete, keep that in mind. And we continue to talk with him and others. But at this point, we have not received information that bullying played a role in this crime.
Suspect Bobby Gladden is undergoing a mental health evaluation at a hospital. Again, he has been charged as an adult. Police say he had 21 rounds of ammunition with him yesterday. They also recovered a bottle of vodka, believe he had taken a few sips of it, but police say they do not believe he was impaired at the time of this shooting. His stepfather was charged with illegal possession of a firearm and possession of marijuana. That is the result of the search of his mother's house up in Northeast Baltimore County yesterday afternoon. The gun used, the double-barreled shotgun used, police say, came from the home of his natural father. That man lives in Middle River. No charges have been filed at this point against him. We will have much more as the day develops from the investigation. Now we go to Perry Hall and Kim Dacey live there. Kim?
Well, thanks, Jane. Daniel, the victim in this case, remains in critical condition at shock trauma. The students held a prayer vigil outside this morning for him before heading back to classes. A sign that says, "Pray for Daniel," now sits out front of Perry Hall High School. Daniel is the 17-year-old student shot by a classmate in the cafeteria on Monday, the first day of school. Students say Daniel has Down syndrome and was well known and liked at the school.
He had the best personality. He just loved being around people.
He was the sweetest thing ever. Such a sweetheart. Always happy and smiling. So, yeah, it's a shame.
Police say Daniel was the only person hit when classmate Bobby Gladden opened fire in the cafeteria Monday. The school was evacuated and sent students home. They returned Tuesday to start the school year again.
It's a little scary. It is. I know there's going to be more security here and everything, but it's probably going to be the safest day.
I'm not really scared because I know that the threat is gone. I just think today's going to be more of a getting back into the gist of just going to school.
Parents we spoke to were concerned about their children returning today. Some think students should have had the day off because of the violence.
Because the students were really traumatized. She was crying all day yesterday because she was in the cafeteria. And I feel they should have given them at least a day off to, you know, process everything before bringing them back to school.
It's kind of scary. I am kind of scared to send her back, but what else am I to do? I'm going to be on pins and needles all day at work worrying about, you know, what's going to happen. But it's scary.
School officials say they have crisis teams on hand to support the kids, and they thought it was important to get the students back into a normal routine.
And having them in the environment, as we've discovered and talking to teachers this morning, that our students have been very eager to talk with their teachers and now rallying around the victim and rallying around the school and the community to help in any way they can.
Many Facebook pages have gone up in support of Daniel, the victim in this case, and students here say they are praying for his recovery. Reporting live in Perry Hall, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.